Well, maps, especially Ordnance Survey maps, are crammed with information about the countryside. Rivers, forests, churches, battlefields and castles, a speciality of this part of the country, all are marked. But to see them, a car is a must. Well, we've looked at car hire in other countries we've visited, and it's something that shouldn't be discounted at home. And that doesn't just apply to those who don't own a car themselves. It's useful if your own car doesn't stand up to the rigours of the family holiday. And the cost? Well, a Cortina GXL like this is expensive at around £54 a week. Better value is a Cortina 1600 at £37 or a Viva for £33. If you hire for a week, there's no charge for mileage, and with this particular company, you become a temporary member of the AA. So, your motoring should be problem-free. Then, armed with map and car, you really can explore the countryside. There are few more intimate ways of communing with the country than camping. This privately owned site for 26 tents and 15 static caravans at Simmons Yat near Ross is fairly typical. Set amid some of the best known scenery in the Wye Valley, the camp's facilities include loos, cafe, a nearby shop and somewhere to buy gas cylinders. There are no showers, but that's reflected in the camping charges of 25 pence a head each night. Incidentally, it's worth mentioning that some of the best value campsites here, as in the rest of the country, are run by the Forestry Commission. In this case, in the Forest of Dean, a couple of miles away. At the moment, this part of the world has its own distinct country pace. The tourist or visitor blends in with the countryside. He doesn't yet dominate. In fact, over-commercialism would be the worst possible thing to happen here. And so far, there are no signs of this happening. Indeed, some of the hotel groups are actively trying to spread the influx of tourists into the months either side of high season by offering special weekend deals. For instance, from £7, you can have two nights in a local hotel with full board. And this compares with an average bed and breakfast rate in hotels in the Wye Valley of around £3.25 a night. And round here there's a profusion of comfortable hotels which still have character. And don't miss the chance to try a glass of locally brewed cider in a pub like this, the Cottage of Content, in the village of Carey. And contentment really sums up the kind of feelings you're likely to take away from a holiday here in the heart of England.